To understand how a universe could be conscious, we need to rethink everything we know about consciousness itself. Most of us believe consciousness comes from our brains, end of story. But what if that's just the tip of the iceberg? In the past decade, a revolutionary idea called integrated information theory has suggested something mind-bending. Consciousness isn't just created by brains. It might be everywhere, in everything, just in different amounts. Think about temperature. Everything has a temperature, from the coldest reaches of space to the hottest stars. It's not a yes or no thing, it's a spectrum. What if consciousness works the same way? Let's start with what we know. In your brain right now, 86 billion neurons are firing away, sharing information in an intricate dance. Each neuron by itself isn't conscious, but together they create something magical, your conscious experience. Now, here's where it gets interesting. This pattern, network sharing information, isn't unique to brains. We see it in fungal networks beneath forests, sharing nutrients and information between trees. We see it in how galaxies cluster together, connected by invisible threads of dark matter, forming what astronomers call the cosmic web. We even recreated it ourselves with the internet, billions of computers sharing information across the globe. The pattern is everywhere, networks within networks, sharing information, creating something greater than the sum of their parts. And at the smallest scale, quantum physics shows us particles that appear to communicate instantaneously across any distance. Einstein called it spooky action at a distance. We now call it quantum entanglement. So here's the wild part. Our universe has 200 billion galaxies, each containing billions of stars, all connected in this vast cosmic web. If consciousness emerges from connected systems sharing information, well, you can see where this is going. But if the universe has the building blocks for consciousness, how does it all come together? Here's something that might blow your mind. No one tells a snowflake how to form its intricate patterns. It just happens through a process scientists call self-organization. You see it everywhere. In the spiral of galaxies, in the hexagonal cells of a beehive, in the way sand dunes ripple across a desert. The universe has this uncanny ability to create order from chaos, all by itself. Think about it. Our universe started as a soup of simple particles. Then those particles joined to form atoms. Atoms clustered into molecules. Molecules became stars and planets. Simple cells evolved into complex life, and here we are, conscious beings trying to understand it all. Scientists have even recreated this in computers. Feed simple rules into a program, let it run, and watch as complex patterns emerge that look eerily similar to living systems. But here's the really wild part. The way our brains organize themselves as we grow looks remarkably similar to how the cosmic web formed over billions of years. It's as if the universe uses the same patterns over and over, just at different scales. So, what if consciousness isn't something that just appeared in brains one day? What if it's the natural result of the universe's tendency to create ever more complex systems? Recent research in neuroscience suggests consciousness might emerge when information in a system reaches a certain threshold of complexity and integration, like water freezing into ice at exactly 0 degrees Celsius. If that's true, and the universe is one vast, interconnected system becoming more complex over time, could it be gradually waking up? But this leads us to an even more mind-bending question. If the universe is organizing itself towards greater complexity and consciousness, is there evidence we can actually observe and measure? Take the famous double slit experiment. Fire single particles at a screen with two slits, and they create an interference pattern as if they're waves. But here's the weird part. This only happens when we're not looking. Try to measure which slit the particle goes through, and the pattern vanishes. Then, there's quantum entanglement. Einstein's spooky action at a distance. Two particles can become so deeply connected that affecting one instantly affects the other, even if they're on opposite sides of the universe. It's as if the space between them doesn't exist at all. In 2022, physicists conducted an experiment suggesting that the very fabric of space-time might be fundamentally quantum entangled. It's like the universe has a hidden nervous system connecting everything at the deepest level. But it gets even crazier. Recent experiments suggest that quantum systems might have a kind of memory. Change something in the present, and it can affect the past. It's as if matter itself can learn and adapt. The patterns we see in these quantum behaviors, connection, memory, adaptation, are eerily similar to the basic properties of consciousness, and they're built into the very foundation of reality. Some physicists now suggest that space, time, and matter might be emergent properties of something more fundamental, information, just like how your consciousness emerges from the information processing in your brain. Think about that for a moment. Everything we consider real, this video, your device, you, me, the entire universe, might be more like a thought than a thing. A cosmic computation playing out across billions of light years. Scientists are now developing new experiments to test these ideas. They're looking for patterns in cosmic radiation that might reveal the universe's underlying structure. They're building quantum computers that could simulate consciousness itself. But if the universe really is conscious, processing information at every scale from quantum to cosmic, that raises an even bigger question. What does it mean for us? Are we just small-scale echoes of a larger cosmic mind? For thousands of years, humans have wondered if there's something more to reality than what we see. Ancient cultures saw consciousness in everything: rivers, mountains, stars. Modern science dismissed these ideas as primitive thinking, but now cutting-edge physics is suggesting something remarkable. Those ancient cultures might have been onto something, not in a mystical way, but in a deep mathematical sense. This idea that consciousness might be fundamental to reality has a name: panpsychism. And while it was once considered fringe philosophy, it's gaining serious attention in scientific circles. Leading physicists and philosophers are asking, what if consciousness isn't produced by the brain, but rather channeled by it? Like how a radio doesn't create music, it receives it. If the universe is conscious, it changes everything. Our role in the cosmos, the nature of life, the possibility of alien intelligence, even what happens after death. Think about evolution. We usually see it as a random process. But if the universe has an inherent tendency toward consciousness and complexity, then maybe we're not an accident. Maybe consciousness using matter to explore itself is what the universe does. This doesn't mean every atom is walking around having deep thoughts. Remember our temperature analogy. Consciousness might exist in degrees. A thermostat might have a tiny amount, a worm more, a human even more, and the universe as a whole, well, right now, scientists are developing new ways to test these ideas. They're looking for signatures of consciousness in quantum systems. They're studying how complex systems emerge and evolve. They're even trying to measure consciousness itself. But here's the most profound implication. If the universe is conscious, then we're not just in the universe. We're of it. Through us, through our consciousness, the universe is experiencing itself. Every time we make a scientific discovery, create art, fall in love, or simply wonder about our place in the cosmos, we might be the universe growing more aware of itself. Remember how we started, with your consciousness emerging from billions of connected neurons? Maybe our individual consciousness is just one node in a much larger network. Maybe we're all part of something far greater than we ever imagined. The evidence is mounting, the mathematics works. The patterns align. We might be on the verge of the greatest discovery in human history. That consciousness isn't something we have. It's something we are. And it goes all the way down and all the way up. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.